All right. Hi there, everyone. My name is Christian. If you're just coming to the Pivot Protocol, or to you're seeing this as part of my new IBS protocol, welcome. You're in the right place. Or let me say that you're in the right place if, number one, you've had enough. You know you've had enough of sort of merry-go-round. Those of you suffering with long-standing digestive illness, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. It's where you go to the doctor, you get another sort of a diagnosis that doesn't actually make good sense, and then you start on a medication that actually ends up causing either worse problems or different problems, but almost certainly doesn't get to the bottom of what's going on inside your body. And if that's you, and you've had enough of that model, and you're tired, and you're ready to get off of that merry-go-round, then you are in the right place. And I will add also that it's very important that you're also willing to do something different. I mean, most of the people running around with digestive illness will never get well going to the modern medical system. That's not even a knock on modern medicine. Anybody who knows my work over any period of time, actually the very first thing that I do in all of my work is to lay out exactly what modern medicine is great at. And it is great. It is a miraculous, incredible, life-saving medical system, but not for chronic conditions. And therein lies the rub, because most people keep going back over and over to the modern medical system to try to make it do something that it's not designed to do, which is fix your chronic digestive illness. So if any part of that makes sense to you, you're in the right place, and if you're willing to learn something new, if you're willing to do something that's a little unusual at first, then there's an overwhelming probability that you're going to be like many of the hundreds and even now thousands of other people who have discovered this self-healing method. Maybe were skeptical in the beginning, but took the plunge, got started. The thing about the protocol and the methodology that I teach is the better you understand it, the further along you go, the more mastery you have over your digestive system, and not just digestion, but your body's ability to heal what's going on inside you. And so when your organs get very badly out of balance and things are really crazy and you have reflux and IBS and all the symptoms that go along with those lovely conditions, you know how to put yourself back on track quickly. Okay, that's, in our opinion here, that's something worth knowing. And the very best asset that you could invest in terms of your health and longevity is to learn how to heal your body's self-healing system. Most of these chronic digestive symptoms can be done away with, and permanently. I mean, yes, you could go back to doing stupid things and causing yourself all kinds of misery, but why would you do that? So once you have this skill, you have it for life. And once you understand what it is that is really going on inside you, how your body operates, these are the things that I'm teaching you: how to understand your symptoms, a different model of cause and effect. The example that I give over and over in the Pivot Protocol for reflux sufferers, does it really make sense that suddenly, miraculously, right around the time that drug companies came up with acid-blocking medication, does it really make any actual logical medical sense to anybody that your stomach just began producing too much acid and, oh, conveniently, we have a pill to fix that? If your stomach acid wasn't necessary, why would it be there in the first place? How can you digest if you're inhibiting your stomach's ability to promote good, strong, healthy juices and stomach acid, which is very necessary for the proper breakdown of your food? There's no logical sense. That doesn't make sense. The cause and effect model don't add up. And so I'm teaching you a different way of understanding, hey, if you're fatigued or you have difficulty swallowing, you feel like something's stuck here, that's an indicator of something going wrong in your organs. And we know exactly what that is. There's a medical model that actually incorporates that kind of data, and then you, the patient, can figure out what to do about that without going back to your doctor, without getting stuck on another medication. That's a tremendously valuable thing to understand, and this goes very, very deep. There's dozens of symptoms that you can come to understand, interpret correctly, and then apply a solution that helps that organ come back into the right balance with the other organs that are working inside you to promote good digestion and self-healing. Okay? So if any part of that makes sense to you, then I hope you stick around long enough to really find out about the protocol that I teach here for chronic digestive problems. At either end of your reflux, we think of typically, it is the proverbial tip of the iceberg. This is the symptom in the upper part of your digestive tract that indicates that things down below are getting bad, right? You don't just have reflux. You have reflux plus something else going on underneath that causing your reflux. Okay, and it could be several somethings, right? For most of you, it's multiple imbalances, as you'll come to find out. For IBS, that's typically a very serious problem deep in the intestinal tract, at the other end of your digestive system. Deep in your abdomen is lower down, right? That is a deeper problem for the body. And so people with IBS tend to suffer just absolute misery. And if you have IBS, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But let me just say this. In this video, now that I've said all of that, I want to talk about anxiety. And a very important, I always try to make two points about anxiety. First of all, a lot of people write in, maybe you're one of them, asking about, I'm really nervous that I have a friend who just found out she has stage 4 esophageal cancer. It's an absolute horror show of a diagnosis. You don't want it, right? I mean, you want to do your very best to prevent that kind of outcome. Any kind of deep organ cancer, deep illness, deep within your body, especially malignancy of any kind, these are the risks of leaving untreated a very serious chronic digestive problem. And naturally, knowing that you're bound to be susceptible to the kinds of thoughts and emotions that arise from, gee, am I headed over a cliff here? I have symptoms that are raging out of control, and I'm very, very worried about that. Well, that's natural. That's a natural state of mind. Those two things, the one naturally leads to the other. It's like, gee, I can't get control of my digestive health, and I think I'm spinning out of control. Am I headed toward a cancer diagnosis and things like this? And these kind of anxious thoughts are a normal part of being sick. Stop and think for a second. I used to teach doctors about this too. You don't have to be a medical professional to understand that if you're in pain a lot, like chronic, serious, debilitating pain, like millions of people are, how are you not going to be depressed at some point in that journey? Right? The idea that you could somehow have a serious chronic pain condition and not be headed toward depression, which is like, this sucks, it's never going to change, it's always going to be this way, and I can't get out of it no matter what I do. That one of the key characteristics of depression is learned helplessness. So then if we take that same logic, right, and bring it over to the digestive model, many, many people with serious symptoms are very, very concerned about their future and like, I can't turn this thing around. I think I'm headed for real trouble. And that constant low level, or sometimes like screaming in your ear, level of preoccupation, hoping that something good is going to come. Okay, what do you do about this? What do you do when you're really that tweaked and that blown out about the possibility of very, very serious diagnosis coming at you like a freight train because your organs are absolutely in an uproar? Well, before I tell you what you should do about it and how I recommend that people deal with such a eventuality, or at least a possible eventuality, right? There's another very important thing to understand about the mind-body connection. We all know that I used to ask doctors this question a lot, if you think certain thoughts, could you cause yourself to be ill? Well, we've all had the experience of, and seen perhaps in somebody, because it's always easier to see it in somebody else, but thinking bad thoughts, thinking super negative, terrible things all the time is certainly going to affect your physical health at some point, right? It's impossible, like to the point that you're so miserable you can't even get yourself out of bed and get going. I mean, that's already affecting your life, whether or not you're developing symptoms. But certainly being forced, focused on real morbid kind of misery, right, and the horrors of the world and just the difficulties of life around you, it is a wonderful one-way ticket to very seriously, let's just say a ticket to possible poor health, physical symptoms, right? But most people forget that the converse is also true, and that with mind-body, the mind-body connection, and one of the things that is so important to realize and understand with chronic digestive illness is there's another reason that you feel anxious when you are sick with chronic digestive symptoms. If your body is breaking down, naturally you're going to be preoccupied, but one organ in particular is responsible for and is linked to the emotion of anxiety, of preoccupation and worry, and it is your principal digestive organ. Now, I tell you more about this in the protocol, but essentially when your spleen is breaking down, when it is not able to do its proper function, I won't go into what that is here, that's all inside the program. What does your spleen do inside your body? The modern medical system has its version of what the spleen does, but it's not a very empowering vision of how that organ actually works. Older medical systems have a much deeper appreciation of how each of your organs works and how they work together to promote good, healthy, in this case, digestive function. And when your spleen is breaking down, when it is not able to do, and I give you all the reasons why your spleen will break down and how to recognize exactly what is happening, if your spleen is worn out, if your spleen is tired, and also I teach you how to fix that. When your spleen is exhausted and can no longer keep up with the workload of digesting and processing and extracting nutrients and helping your body to get nourishment, you will feel anxious. It's a one-to-one correlation. That organ is related to that emotion. Now, this is a far-fetched thing for people with no experience of medicine at all, but especially even medical professionals in our modern medical system, to associate a certain mental emotional state, a psychological profile, if you will, with the function of your organs. But this is exactly how it works. This is precisely what is going on. And so worry makes your spleen worse off, and your spleen being broken down, damaged, weak, exhausted, makes your psychological state more extreme. Okay, and the good news about that is, first of all, you have some control over your thoughts. Everybody has some control. If you're not willing to accept that, you're not going to get very far, probably in life, but it's certainly going to be hard for you to heal yourself. You're not as is now so often taught in higher education, you're not a victim, right? You're not 100% a victim, and if you think you are, it's probably a good place to start, is to examine that attitude. But the idea that you could come up with a plan for fixing your thoughts, but also here, and this is my message to all of you in this video, the solution to constant worry about your health is to get busy. The solution is to know at the end of the day, when normally when you're flooded with worrisome thoughts about your health or your future or whatever else, is to know without a doubt that, number one, you did everything that you could during the day to fix yourself, and that you trust that good things will come from that. Over time, if you continue to get the details right. And number two, to be so focused and so engrossed in, if you will, your healing process that you actually don't have time or energy left to worry. What am I talking about? Well, the PIVOT protocol and the IBS protocol are step-by-step methodologies. There's a piece for you to learn, and then you're going to implement. You learn, you implement. You learn, you implement over and over again. And you're dialing in exactly which details you need for your specific situation until the whole thing, as I describe it, it's like getting the gears to mesh. And suddenly your digestive system starts to work again properly, and you've brought your organs back into the proper balance. And as your digestive system begins to work better, well, now, naturally, you have far fewer reasons to be concerned, okay? When you're upset and worried about your health because your organs are acting out and blowing up inside you, well, that's a normal way to be, but fixing your organs will fix your mental emotional state. And the way you fix your organs is to learn the kind of self-healing methodology that I teach in this very unusual program that I've put together for you. So all of this becomes clear once you get started. I'm going to lay out for you exactly how your organs are malfunctioning, what we need to do to get them back into working order and working harmony, we like to say, right? That's a technical term in this medical system. And you know what's interesting is once you get started on this, and once you really decide to make yourself well, My point about the protocol is not that it's magic or that it's going to, you know, you see people like selling herbs and it's some kind of magical solution to everything, right? All of that is nonsense. Anybody who's been around medicine any amount of time very quickly comes to understand that all of that is good marketing, right? But it's very poor medicine. And that if you're serious about getting well again, the very best shot that you have is your self-healing system. It's just that simple. People write to me like, oh, I'm 80 years old and nothing, you know, like I'm really breaking down and everything the doctor's doing. It's like, you don't have another choice except to try to see if your body will respond and make itself better again. You're not getting out of the obvious conclusion that you're coming to, that modern medicine is really designed to keep you going on these medications, to keep you coming back. That's not that's a good means, but it's a means to their end. It's not a means to your end, which should be healing, which is to feel better again, which is to live your life without digestive symptoms. To get out of that merry-go-round, to get off of that ride, you have to be focused on the very best thing that you have going for you, that you have control over, which is to get your body working again properly, your organs working in harmony, so that your body can fix itself on its own, okay? And so understand that if you're really, really beat down, if you're really scared, if you're really worried about what's happening to you inside you, you can focus yourself so totally on exactly what am I doing today? I learned this, I'm going to implement it. Especially once you see some momentum toward healing, you build momentum to pull yourself out of that kind of anxiety and even depression. Okay? And that's my goal for all of you, is that you very quickly start to see that, like, wait a second, I have way more power over my digestive illness than my doctor led me to believe. Okay? It's not your doctor's fault. They're not taught this stuff either. But it is your responsibility. And responsibility equals control. If you're willing to learn this and take responsibility, here's what I'm going to do today to fix myself. I've made it so simple for you to do that. So again, if you're coming to the PIVOT protocol, IBS protocol for the very first time, welcome. And I hope you decide to go for it. I have a lot in this material that's really, really valuable for people in your situation. Thanks very much.